Storytellers Unite. I hope that you're all doing really well. I'm thinking that this week is a returning back to school week, so I'm just hoping that the transition has gone as well as possible for all of you. And if you're not going back to school with your children, then I hope you're doing okay in lockdown still. This week's story is The Princess and the Pea, and this is just your weekly reminder to please feel free to share this with as many parents and carers as possible at this time who may find it useful. And if you do enjoy it, and more importantly, if your child enjoys it, then please feel free to subscribe and click the big thumbs up below. I'm going to jump straight into it. Thank you so much for watching. Hello, Storytellers! Welcome back to Storytellers Unite. I hope that you are having a wonderful day so far. Now, I am wearing a sparkly tiara and some of my favourite princess jewellery. We are reading The Princess and the Pea today. If you have heard of The Princess and the Pea, can you pretend to put on your best royal crown? It might be a king's crown, it might be a queen's crown, okay? Or it might be a prince or a princess. So if you have heard of The Princess and the Pea, can you lift up your crown for me and put it on like that? Oh, fantastic work. Let me see you putting your crowns on. Well done, guys. Okay, now before we start, what do we need to do? Our storytelling chant. So, when I say storytellers, you say unite. Are you ready? I said, are you ready? Storytellers! Storytellers! Oh, fantastic chanting, guys. You are getting louder and louder every week. Once upon a time, there was a prince who wanted to marry a princess, but she would have to be a real princess. He travelled all over the world. Can you show me a big circle to show me like the planet Earth? Show me the world with a circle. Great actions, guys. He travelled all over the world to find one, but he couldn't find a real princess anywhere. There were lots of princesses, but it was difficult to find out whether they were real ones. There was always something about them that just didn't seem right. The prince felt very confused. Can you show me a confused face? Let me see. Great faces, guys. All this searching has made me very tired and I feel lonelier than I did before, the prince said to his brother as he rode his horse back through the palace gates. I guess I'll just have to wait till she arrives on my doorstep, joked the prince. That evening, there was a terrible storm. There was thunder and lightning and the rain poured down. Can you show me some actions for the weather? There was thunder and lightning and the rain poured down. There was thunder and lightning and the rain poured down. Good copying, guys. Suddenly, there was a knocking heard at the palace gate. Can you find somewhere to knock? You might have a door nearby, or a floor, or a window, and do a big hard knock for me. There was a knocking at the palace gate, and the old king went to open it. Who on earth would be knocking on the door at this time? Thought the king. Can you say that for me? Who on earth would be knocking on the door at this time? Try again. Who on earth would be knocking on the door at this time? Thought the king. It was a princess. She was stood by the front gate in the pouring rain. But goodness gracious, the wind and the rain had ruined her hair, her makeup, and her beautiful dress was in tatters. The water ran down from the top of her head all the way to her sparkly gold shoes. Can you point to the top of your head? And right down to your toes. Good pointing, guys. Even though she had got caught in the rain and her royal carriage had mysteriously disappeared, she insisted that she was a real princess. And the old king believed her. Well, we'll soon find that out, thought the old queen. But she said nothing. She went into the spare bedroom, took all the bedding off the bed, and laid a pea at the bottom. Can you find a pretend pea for me? Very, very small pea, okay? And I want you to place it down like this. Find a pea and place it down. Then she took 20 mattresses and laid them on top of the pea. 20 mattresses. I've only got one mattress in my bed. I don't know about you guys, but 20, that is loads. The queen showed the princess to her bed for the night. Sleep well, my dear, the old queen chimed, hoping this girl wasn't a real princess. Otherwise, she'd feel the pee under her mattress straight away. In the morning, they all sat round and ate some yummy breakfast. Can you guys have a think about what is your favourite breakfast food? Have a think. And then I want you to pretend that you are eating it. My favourite for a treat is pancakes. So I'm going to pretend to roll up my pancake and eat it up. Oh, yummy. Mine's got chocolate spread. An ice cream. What are you eating at home? They all sat round and ate breakfast. How did you sleep? Asked the old queen. Oh, very badly, said the princess. I have barely closed my eyes all night. Goodness only knows what was in the bed. I was lying on something hard. It created a lump in my mattress and it was terribly uncomfortable. Now they knew that she was a real princess because she had felt the pee right through the 20 mattresses. The old queen couldn't believe it. Only a real princess would have noticed that. So the prince asked the princess on a date and they quickly fell in love and got married. He knew that he had found a real princess. And that's the end of the story. Thank you so much for doing such wonderful listening, guys. I will see you next time on Storytellers Unite.